Hey everyone, and welcome back to my channel. My name is Josh, and this is your stimulus check update for the next stimulus package for Thursday, January 21st. I hope everyone is having a great day so far. In this video, I'll be discussing updates in regards to the current relief package and the third stimulus check. I'll also be discussing unemployment, city mayor is pushing for recurring stimulus payments, and then I'll be wrapping up this video by answering some of the comments and questions that I received in my previous video. But first, if you wouldn't mind real quickly liking this video, give me a big thumbs up. It really just helps with the YouTube algorithm in terms of pushing this video out to other viewers like you and hopefully helping other people like you as well. Okay, so with the weekly jobless claims for the week ending in January 16th finally in, the Labor Department reported that the amount totaled 900,000. Even though this is slightly better than Wall Street's estimate of 925,000 jobless claims, it's still a good bit higher than what has been in previous weeks. This also comes as a stark reminder, according to White House National Economic Council Director Brian Deese, that we must act now in order to get immediate relief to American families. At the moment, in total, we have nearly 16,000 Americans on unemployment benefits, with a third of them on the Pandemic Unemployment Assistance Program. This, of course, is the unemployment program designed for gig workers, as those jobs still remain scarce. In a statement, Deese said, Biden has already outlined a set of decisive actions in the American Rescue Plan to extend unemployment insurance, finish the job in providing $2,000 in direct relief to Americans, and ensure that millions of our families who are struggling to make ends meet, put food on the table, and keep a roof over their heads in the midst of this crisis are able to get to the other side with dignity. Speaking of stimulus checks, 34 mayors from across the country are calling on President Biden and Vice President Harris for recurring payments each month through the duration of this pandemic. You can see their ad up on the screen, which was also included in a full-page ad in the Washington Post. In the ad, it says, one more check is not enough. Then it includes various reasons on one more one-time payment of $2,000 just isn't enough. Of course, the sad thing here is that they're already presuming the next check will be for $2,000. As Joe Biden has the current proposal, the checks for the majority of people will be just $1,400 on top of the $600 people have already received. For adult dependents who didn't receive the last round of direct payments, they would be the ones receiving $2,000. Now, one interesting thing to note is the fact that now the Vice President, Kamala Harris, was one of the lawmakers who back in the summer was backing recurring monthly stimulus payments. Now that she's the vice president, will she continue to push for those, or will she take a backseat to Biden's plan? With that said, would you like for Congress to pass a bill for recurring monthly stimulus payments, or do you believe that it would simply be too costly and therefore be against it? Let me know what your thoughts are in the comments section below. So here we have an ad by various lawmakers calling on recurring monthly stimulus checks, but in all reality, that's probably just not going to happen. At the moment, we're already looking at nearly $2 trillion in spending in this next relief package. If we're going to add recurring stimulus checks, that's going to add even more. The bill already has enough opposition from Republicans as is, so it's just not that realistic. Of course, being that they can pass any bill through the Senate with only Democrat votes and zero Republican votes under budget reconciliation, it's still possible, but highly unlikely. At the moment, Democrats are looking at a couple of different options. The first option would be to attempt passing a bigger relief package, which could also take a longer period of time to pass. With this plan, they would attempt to pass something similar to Biden's proposal with some minor changes. The good thing about this option for Democrats is that they could get all the aid that they're seeking and pass it through with all Democratic votes under budget reconciliation. The bad thing is, you're already being pretty divisive early on in the Biden administration when you promise voters bipartisanship. You'd also have almost zero room for error as you would need all Democrats to be on board with the plan, including Joe Manchin, who already said he would oppose a bill unless it was targeted to people who really needed the aid the most. The second option they're looking at is a smaller bipartisan bill that would quickly get out cash for vaccine distribution in addition to a third round of stimulus checks. This package would obviously cost much less than $1.9 trillion, and it would also appease just enough Republicans to where they could get it through with more than 60 votes. The good thing about this bill, as I mentioned, is it would demonstrate that the Biden administration is seeking bipartisanship, and it would start things off on the right foot. The bad thing is, for Democrats at least, is they wouldn't be able to get all of the aid that they were seeking. Either way, the important thing will be to pass something and to pass it very soon. Okay, so at this point in time, I'm going to move right along to answering some of the comments and questions that I received in my previous video. And if you do have any other comments or questions for me, please feel free to leave them in the comment section below. I do try to answer as many of the comments and questions as I possibly can, but for those comments and questions I'm not able to respond to, I do try to pick some of the more popular ones to answer in the next video in video form. Okay, so without further ado, let me go ahead and jump into the first comment of today's video, which is from Tina. Tina says, "Hey Josh, my husband and I have a new bank account. Our checks went into our bank, but we had the bank account closed, so it went back to the IRS. What do we do now? Wait to fill out the non-filers tool? I don't want to mess this up." Okay, thank you so much for your question. And in this case, since you changed bank accounts since you received your first direct payment, then you'll need to claim a $1,200 credit on the tax returns that you filed this year. In the first round of direct payments, if the money was sent to an incorrect bank account, the IRS would then reprocess your payment and send you a check in the mail instead. This time around, however, they're asking that you claim the money as a credit on the tax returns you filed this year. So even though I'm sure you would much rather receive this money as a direct deposit or a check in the mail, receiving it as a tax refund is certainly better than never receiving it at all. Okay, moving along to the next question of today's video, which is from Carol. Carol says, "I did not receive the first stimulus check because I made too much money. Now, in 2020, my income is lower. Will I receive a stimulus check this time around?" Okay, thank you so much for your question, Carol. And if your income dropped low enough in 2020 in order to be eligible for the second direct payment, then yes, you will. So let's say, for example, you earned $300,000 in income in 2019, which would have made you ineligible to receive the $1,200 stimulus check. However, this year, if you only earned $50,000, then you would have been eligible once again since you made less than $75,000. So you would not only be eligible to receive the second direct payment of $600, but you would also be eligible for the $1,200 one from the first round as well. However, what you'll need to do in order to receive this money is to claim an $1,800 credit on the tax returns that you file this year. Also, if Congress passes another stimulus check for $1,400 or $2,000, then you should also be eligible for that one, depending on what the income requirements end up being. Since we still don't know what the income cap will end up being for the next stimulus check, it's hard saying for sure, but I'll definitely make sure to keep you updated one way or another. All right, so on that note, I'm gonna go ahead and wrap up this video. If you did enjoy the content in this video and you'd like to see more videos like it, please consider subscribing to my YouTube channel. It is completely free to do so, and it's a great support to me. Also, if you'd like to receive two free socks from Webull, with both of them valued all the way up to $1,600 each, or one free sock from Robinhood just for signing up and linking your bank account, please feel free to claim those free socks by clicking the link in the description box below. And finally, if you join Rakuten with my referral link in the description box below and spend at least $20, Rakuten will give you $20 cash back. This means that you can buy an item through Rakuten with one of their referral links, such as Nike, for $20, which would be right around $22 after tax, and Rakuten will give you $20 just for making that purchase. This is just an incredible deal that I would love for everyone to take advantage of. Okay, so until next time, I'll see you guys, and I hope you have a great day today.